nearly two dozen parked vehicles at the Terminal 3 of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport caught fire Monday. Airport authorities are still investigating the cause of the blaze, but fire respondents believe this might have been a grass fire incident worsened by the extreme heat. No injuries were reported and flight operations were unaffected. The Manila International Airport Authority now seeking accountability from the private company that occupies the parking space.
Ano ko sa kanya na liability niyo, kailangan hanapin daw niya yung cause ng ano, yung cause ng fire. Tapos lahat daw ng nangyari ay sasagutin nila. Sabi ko, siguraduhin mo kung anong sasagot mo. Hindi po pwede yung sabi mo sa amin ngayon. Sabi ko, tanungin mo para pag tinanong tayo ng mga tao, sasabihin namin kayo ang magbabayad. Bayaran nyo ba? Papalitan ba nyo yung mga nasunog na sasakyan? You have to be very specific, sabi ko. Huwag sila sana mag-iiwan ng mga gamit na madaling masunog. Gaya na sinasabi, huwag kayong mag-iiwan ng mga, baka may mga rubbing alcohol doon, baka flammable. Yun ang kwento ng police, ay yung fire department kanina. At kung maaari, kung pwede. Kaya ngayon, lahat ng mga, yung mga parking areas na yun, sabi ko nga, pwede bang dinitanggalin yung ano? Pinapalinis kayo yung ano, yung pinapalinis yung may nakalist dito, yung mga dried na talahib.
An analyst warns against the rebranding of the political party led by former President Rodrigo Duterte. The Partido Democratico Pilipino, or PDP, recently dropped the second part of its name, Laban, which stands for the Lakas ng Bayan Party founded by the late Ninoy Aquino. Attorney Tony Lavinia sees the move as a way for the Duterte camp to distance the party from its roots.
Ang feeling ko, gusto nilang itabi, itaboy yung kasaysayan ng, kasi makakasaysayan yung PDP Laban, di ba, kasi linked to Ninoy Aquino, linked to Nene Pimentel. They basically are saying, from now on, Duterte na ito. Di ba? This is a Duterte party. Kasi sa totoo lang, hindi man kasama si Duterte sa party na yan. Sumama na lang siya nung 2016 elections, di ba, yung tumakbo siya. Kasi yun ang political party na kumukup sa kanya. It doesn't make sense kasi then they will lose watchers, diba? They will not be accredited. They have to start accreditation again. I thought it was foolish that they are doing this. Wala namang clear na dahilan. Kasi mukhang ang magkalaban naman ngayon, Marcos at Duterte, diba? Hindi naman Duterte versus Dilawan.
Senator Coco Pimentel, who is the son of one of PDP Laban's founders, also slams the move.
Kung gusto rin naman pala nila ng ibang partido, kasi binago nila lahat sa PDP Laban. Ba't din nila sila nagbuo ng sarili nilang partido? Hindi naman bawal yun. Wala pang masasaktan, wala pang aangal. Sayang ang history ng PDP Laban, kaya ipaglalaban namin yan. Ano? Meron, yung kami mga lehitimong PDP Laban, original plus yung true believers sa ideology ng PDP Laban, itutuloy namin ang kausa ng PDP Laban at ilalaban namin even to the Supreme Court. Kaya nga may pending case kami dyan.
For the 2025 polls, the party announced the re-election bid of Senators Francis Tolentino, Bongo, and Ronald De La Rosa. Turning now to the strained ties between Vice President Sara Duterte and First Lady Elisa Araneta Marcos, the Vice President unapologetic for any ill feelings she may have caused the First Lady. Joyce Balancho tells us more.
At insurgencia.
Vice President Sara Duterte insists that the sentiments of First Lady Elisa Marcos have nothing to do with her mandate as a government official. This is her response following the admission of the First Lady of her ill feelings towards her in an exclusive interview with Anthony Taberna recently. Elisa Marcos said she was hurt by VP Duterte's reaction when President Marcos Jr. was accused of being a drug addict by her father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, in a Davao rally.
When she went to Davao, Duterte said, "Oh, bangag, bangag, diba?" Imagine a former president calling, ano, bangag. I mean, wow, you had 6 years. Why would you call, ano, bangag, diba? So, and then the camera panned on her, tumatawa. So, syempre, nakita ko, sabi ko, wow, man. I mean, masakit yan. bloodshot na yun sa akin. So, unless she says sorry or whatever, maybe she will, maybe she... She crossed the line.
Mga kababayan, bilang tao, karapatan ni unang ginang Lisa Marcos na makaramdam ng sama ng loob at galit. Subalit, ang kanyang personal na damdamin ay walang kinalaman sa aking mandato bilang isang opisyal ng pamahalaan.
Duterte says she will speak with President Marcos regarding the matter.
Upang makausad tayo, iiwan na natin sa isang pribadong pag-uusap sa pagitan lamang namin ni Pangulong Bongbong Marcos Jr. ang mga susunod na hakbang.
The Vice President also insists that the government should instead focus its attention on problems and challenges that the country is facing.
Patuloy ang pagtaas ng presyo ng pagkain at iba pang mga bilihin. At ito ay mas nagpapahirap pa sa dinaranas na gutom o kawalan ng sapat na pagkain ng mahihirap nating kababayan. Nagbabadya rin ang kakulangan ng supply ng tubig at kuryente, habang talamak na naman ang ipinagbabawal na droga. Samantala, hindi pa rin natatapos ang banta ng kriminalidad, terorismo at insurhensiya sa ating bansa.
A lawmaker, Manila Representative Joel Chua, took up the cudgels for the First Lady, saying her feelings are not mere personal matters that can be cast aside as if they had no weight nor importance. He adds, the Vice President's character and integrity are now in serious question. A political analyst meanwhile warns the Vice President's response could only worsen the tensions between her and the First Lady.
Yung sagot ni VP Duterte parang incongruent dun sa kung ano yung sinasabi ni First Lady. Hindi ina-address yung grievance as they say,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Tapos tipong nagiging high and mighty pa, no? Yung taking the moral high ground.
After the interview with the First Lady was released, VP Duterte and President Marcos both attended the graduation ceremony of the Philippine National Police Academy on Friday. The two sat beside each other during the program and were even seen conversing and laughing with each other. After the program, the two declined to comment if they had discussed the matter concerning the First Lady. Last week, President Marcos clarified that his working relationship with VP Duterte remained the same despite his complicated relationship with her family. As of Monday, President Marcos has not given any statement or reaction following the interview with the First Lady. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Senator Riza Ontivero slams the police for failing to quickly revoke the gun licenses of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. Ontivero says the police should be doing everything to arrest Quiboloy if they truly plan to hold him accountable. The senator called on the new national police chief to lead better and quickly apprehend Quiboloy. The Senate has an arrest order for Quiboloy for snubbing hearings on his alleged abuses against his followers. He is also wanted by local courts over charges of child abuse and human trafficking. China warning against what it called gunboat diplomacy as the Philippines and U.S. hold joint drills. During a naval conference in Qingdao, Zhang Youxia, the vice chairman of China's Central Military Commission, said the sea should not be a stage for countries to flex their military might. He adds countries that make deliberate provocations will only hurt themselves. He insists China remains committed to resolving maritime disputes through dialogue.
As President Xi Jinping has pointed out, the Pacific Ocean is large enough to accommodate all countries of the Pacific. The ocean should not be an arena for countries to show off their force and engage in gunboat diplomacy, but rather a big stage for peaceful coexistence and the promotion of common interest.
Zhang was addressing the 19th meeting of the Western Pacific Naval Symposium, which gathered 180 senior Navy representatives from 29 countries. Representatives from the U.S., U.K., France, Russia, and Japan are among the attendees. The Philippines was notably absent.
As far as I know, China as a host of this symposium has extended the invitations to all member states and observer states. We're not sure about the specific reasons why the Philippines is not attending the event. However, I believe that with the joint efforts of all member states and observer states attending the meeting, the symposium will definitely inject positive energy in promoting maritime security cooperation and mutual trust among the member states and observer states.
Maritime tensions between the Philippines and China have long been simmering, and the Marcos administration's pivot back to Washington was not well received by Beijing. Over 16,000 Filipino and American troops kicked off their annual Balikatan exercises Monday. This year's training focuses on defending the Philippine territory against external threats. It includes naval exercises outside Manila's territorial waters in areas close to Taiwan. 14 countries in Asia and Europe are also taking part as observers.
This exercise represents the essence of unity, collective responsibility, and enduring partnership between the Republic of the Philippines and the United States of America and our partners. It is not a partnership of convenience, but rather a clear reflection of our shared history, unwavering commitment to democracy, and respect for international law in our pursuit of peace and security in the Indo-Pacific region.
We're building military readiness throughout the full range of combined and joint operations here. Balikatan 24 gives us the opportunity to demonstrate advanced, multi-domain, cross-functional combined operations.
The Philippine Coast Guard is also participating in the exercises for the first time, sending six of its ships to Palawan and Northern Luzon. The drills will run until May 10. Let's now get an update on the weather from Pag-asa forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Good morning, Lori.
Good morning, Bettina, and all our viewers and listeners. Cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms will be experienced over Sacsayan, Pasilan, Sulu, Tawi, Tapo Oriental, Davao Occidental, Samar, Northern Samar, Eastern Samar, Catanduanes, Albayan, Sorsogon due to easterlies. So possible flash floods or landslides can be experienced due to moderate to intense heavy rains. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we will generally have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with little chance of rain showers or thunderstorms in the afternoon or evening. And as of today, we're not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone inside the Philippine area of responsibility. And the heat index, that is the forecast heat index for Metro Manila for today, is at around 42 degrees Celsius. That's the latest from Pag-asa. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you very much for that update, Lori.